Yeah, hey man, that art festival was great, man. But there weren't any African Americans from Russian Europe in it. Yeah, it was good. It was good. I mean, it was just absolutely astonishing with all these great musicians and stuff out there. Yeah, I mean, you know, we sports athletes don't even notice things like that. Definitely, man, definitely. It was.
I really love your beaches.
Traditionalism and art, hasatismo, as Marionetta called it, the impassioned glorification of the future, hence the origin of the name futurism. The first manifesto of
he is the one that really described rockets, tank warfare, laser warfare, all the warfare that we're familiar with today. He was writing about and publishing in 1898. So that's what makes Wells and people like Jules Verne just incredible. They're writing about stuff hundreds of years before they're ever developed. Especially when you talk about his role in history, how he metaphysically just changed the entire world. So H.G. Wells, once again, through War of the Worlds, even though it's, you know, two completely different planetary cultures, he's really commenting on Britain and its reactions to the Russians, the Germans, even though it has not happened yet, World War I, this is what he's writing. Then undoubtedly, we are the Lord,
look how interested they are. Man, I can't believe this. Tomorrow I gotta go up to the library for a web quest. Seniors, I can't get anything out of
it. You're gonna be up there one day?
Yeah.
And we're up there 1B2. We're writing an in-class essay on War of the Worlds at this time of the year.
Italian futurism, man. How are we all going to work together? It's like, how are we going to get their attention?
I'm telling you, you could put an X-ray and a film on in front of them, they still fall through.
Yeah, I mean, senioritis, it has hit big time. They are turned off completely.
I just can't get them to pay attention.
There's got to be a way somehow. I just don't know. No tricks don't work anymore.
I don't see it. I haven't thought of anything new. So if you can, I'm all ears.
One of those
smart boards. Smart board would be nice. They don't have any in the library. I'm out of smart ideas.
Hello?
David.
Who is this?
This is God.
What the?
I'll phone them, and they'll listen.
Phone them? Phone who? Who is this?
Phone them, and they'll listen.
Phone them? Phone who?
Phone them, and they'll listen.
Phone them, and they'll listen.
Exciting new dynamic discoveries in science and the artists were reacting to it. Dynamic futurism. If you think of a horse with four legs, dynamic
futurism. The eugenics movement, therefore going under the philosophy of not only Darwin, but others who said that only the strong survive, well, it's those that are living above ground, according to Wells, that really are. This is awesome. Those that are living above ground that really are the ones who are successful in the eugenics movement, which, you know, came into prominence in the late 1890s through the early 1920s. And that's what made H.G. Wells great, was his ability to really, really just see into the future.
Wasted!
Yeah. can soak your bread in wine. It can seem like you are living, like you're having a real good time. And you can do it to your conscience. You can do it all the time. You can do it with a vengeance in the morning after nine. But you know you'll always be waiting, always be waiting for someone else to call.